speaking with Matt in his weird time. No, okay. I'm speaking with Matthew Underwood. What is your favorite animal to have as a pet?
My favorite animal to have as a pet? I have to say, a red-tailed boa constrictor. I used to have one. It was really, really, really big. It got so big I had to give it to the zoo. Because I lived in Santa Monica, and in Santa Monica they have a law. You can get a permit for a snake, but once it gets too big, you have to give it away. So I did. The reason why I love boa constrictors is because they're very emotional, and they get very attached. So if you don't play with it for like 3 days, it gets all mean. It's just like, you know what, you didn't play with me. I don't want to talk to you at all. And then when you do play with them, they get all happy, and they actually really do get happy like a dog. And then once in a while, it slept in my room, and it was so big, it would get up on my, I would sleep on the top bunk, and it would get up in the top bunk, and I'd wake up with a snake in my bed with me. It was quite odd sometimes, because it would wrap around me, and I'd wake up and I'd be like, oh gosh. I've had a red-tailed boa, an anaconda, and a ball python. Anaconda is the not so nice.
If you could be any animal, what would you be and why?
If I could be any animal, it would be a tortoise or a sea turtle, because they live so long and they get to see the entire world. I know tortoises are a little slow, so the whole world to them might be like 10 feet, but it might take them like 100 years to get 10 feet. But the sea turtle gets to see the entire world on their migration, and they live for so long, and I'm sure sea turtles talk to all, whoa, we just turned. I'm sure all the sea turtles talk to all the animals and they give them all advice about how cool the world is. I want to be that kind of animal.
And they let clownfish ride on them.
Oh, yes, they do. They let clownfish ride on them in the Sydney Current. And that's it, yeah. Crush was my favorite, by the way.
What do you think people should do to help care for their animals more?
I think a good way that people can care for their animals more, for one, is care more about their animals. If you feel like your pet doesn't have as good of a home as it deserves, maybe you could try to find someone who might have a better home, no matter how much you love the animal being with you. If the animal would have a more stable life in a better environment, it would be better for the pet. They always say, you know, if you love someone, you know, you gotta learn to let them go. And if you love the animal that much, like I do, like my snakes, I couldn't have them anymore. So what I did was I gave them to the zoo because that was a more stable environment. And I knew they would be treated better and they would get more attention in the zoo. And also, just give your animals a lot of attention because that's one of the things that they love over anything. Because, you know, a lot of times you'll find a very aggressive dog, maybe behind a fence, and you walk, and everyone's always scared of it because everyone walks past the fences, the dog's growling and barking and drooling. And I find that whenever I walk up to one of those animals, I make sure they know that I'm there to love them and I'm there to be really nice to them. And they tend to be nicer to me than they would someone else. And I take my time getting to walk up to them and things. And all they're really looking for is someone to love them because they feel that everyone is going to treat them badly as their owner does. So they're mean to everybody. But when they find that you're going to be nice to them, they attach onto that. And that's what they want. All dogs would be really amazingly nice dogs. I don't think there's any such thing as a born aggressive dog as long as you treat it and bring it up to be a happy, loving dog.
We're on a boat right now. What is your favorite part of being on a boat?
My favorite part about being on the boat is you're so far from society, because I think my view on society is there's only one place that the world doesn't own, and it's the ocean. You know, United States owns the moon, supposedly. You know, we all own our islands, we all own our houses, our properties, our cars, our land, but the ocean is the singular place that nobody in the world owns. And I love that we actually give the earth its, you know, its place to be its own thing. The world owns the ocean. Nobody else does but the world. And I think that's another way that we show respect to the world, and we can show respect to our land as well, you know? We let the earth be the earth. We don't try to change the world as in, like, you know, ripping out all its oil, chopping down all its trees. We let the earth be itself. And I think that's why I love being on the boat, because you're out in the only place that nobody owns.
Thank you.
No problem.